In today's mini lecture, I'm going to talk about the difference between nation branding and destination branding and introduce a little bit about tourism and Korea.
In the contemporary era, nation branding is more important than ever. But if you're a country like Korea, you have a lot of problems to overcome in creating a national image, including the confusion between the North and the South and people's level of perhaps fright about the North. Korea established the Presidential Council on National Branding in 2009 to address this issue. There have been many different campaigns to brand Korea internationally over the years because there are technical, economic, political, and cultural approaches to branding a nation. It's really difficult to figure out the best way to get the world to know the things that you want them to know about your country. According to Anholt, the entire idea of nation branding is perhaps a pipe dream. It is a naive fallacy that national image can somehow be built, reversed, or otherwise manipulated through marketing communications. And the confusion between destination branding, which is a kind of sophisticated tourism promotion, and nation branding, which is understood as the management of the country's overall reputation. It's worth asking if Korea is engaging in nation branding at all, or if it's all destination branding.
Have you ever? Have you ever slept?
I've never slept like that.
Have you ever been to a restaurant?
Never been to a restaurant like that.
Have you ever been to the sea?
No, I have never been to a sea like that.
Have you ever enjoyed nature?
Nature. I would argue, and you probably agree, that the clip that we just saw featuring members of XO promoting Korea is probably not the right way to promote Korea. And it poses some very interesting questions about who they expect to visit Korea and what they really want to teach about the country. A lot of this nation branding in the Korean context is actually really conflated with destination branding. Branding a country and branding a tourism destination are not necessarily the same and shouldn't be approached in the same way at the same time.
One of the ongoing issues here has been the way that, this whole idea of K culture that can be part of destination branding or nation branding, it actually kind of promotes an essentialized or nationalistic view of what Korea is. As of course you know, the government these days is using pop culture for nation branding. And that's kind of interesting because until 1993, there was so much censorship and pop culture was really an object of state control. Then it became a domestic industry, which was supported and protected like any other industry. And then it's only since 2004 that it's been considered part of cultural export and nation branding, which is a profound shift in the government's attitude towards popular culture.
However, it's risky for the government to associate itself too closely with pop culture because pop culture and the goals that pop culture artists and producers have are not the same as the goals of the government, and scandals can arise. But what vision of Korea does the government actually want you to see? And who do they imagine that you are? Do they imagine that you are a K-pop fan and potential tourist to Korea? Do they imagine that you are a government minister from another country or a businessman looking for a new site for his factories? What do they want you to know about Korea and how are they reaching out to you?
I'm going to show you three different videos, and they're from very different time periods. And I want you to think about how they are appealing and who they are reaching with what sort of information about Korea.
Media Sparkling. Imagine you're here. Skiing under the moonlight. Exploring one of the new seven wonders of nature. Catwalking down shopping streets. And experiencing K-pop like never before.
Imagine your Korea!
Oh,